Welcome back, Tomb Raiding Heroes, to another episode of Might & Magic 6, The Mandate of Heaven, with me, Magix. And in this episode, we are finally trying to finish the Tomb of Varn in the Dragon Sands. And of course, I wish you all a happy new year, since I am recording at the 1st of January 2020. So, hope you enjoy this episode, and let's begin!
You heard what she said.
So guys, we continue just where we left off in the last episodes. So we quickly heal. Then we continue our journey. Buffs up. Well, our of power needs to be refreshed. Now again for 7 hours. And yeah, resistances are pretty sweet still. And well, we have gained again like 8 levels now. We had 4 from the dragons and now 4 from the pyramid, and we have nearly gained the 5th level too. So all the slaughtering of genies and Varn defenders seems to pay off. And at the end of the last episode, we found the temple key, yeah, of the water and the first mate's coat, which was Spock. Or KCOPS, if you turn it around. And we still have to enter all the codes in this middle part of the map. But we were missing some of them. What is the first mate's code? Well, as I just read it, it was Spock and downward, so like this, right? KCOPS. KCOPS. And this is also correct. But we are still not done. So, let's continue. And the entire last episode was on the right side and clearing out the left side. Just not this water temple part, because the door to this part is locked. So let's see how big this part is compared to the rest. As you can see, this tomb is so huge. I mean, flavor-wise, it's really great. But I think they could have made the rooms a little bit more smaller. I maybe can take the shortcut with jump. Good thing we have Featherfall. And yeah, let's continue. Let's use the key, right? And see how many enemies awaits us this time. And already the first ambush of Defenders of Varn. But it makes no sense to read it backwards, so I guess it's Varn indeed. And they love to break our bows. Let's continue onwards. Well, it's red in here, but I don't see it on the minimap. Yeah, I guess they were in the corner after all. You're still hitting hard, but well. No, there was still one alive. And some more genies. Okay. But was this everything? I don't believe this. There has to be something in here. Because why would it have been locked otherwise? Ah, you can go down here. It's just very tight in here. And another guardian. Got him. And now it's green. And we found a treasure chest. And this time I take the Glove of Thievery, because the last chest was blowing up. And good thing. We found a third crystal skull. We found the key to the chest in the bibliothèque. And well, I guess a Cavalier Gauntlet of the Gods. And the Navigator's Code. Hey, hey. Good. So, now we have 3 skulls. Only one missing, I guess. We have the key and another scroll, and this one reads Ulus or Zulu. And the gauntlet of the gods. Well, I like fire resistance more, to be honest. Yeah, I guess armor class plus 9 is pointless if every enemy shoots fire at us. Well, it's also better than the intellect plus 10. Yeah, whatever.
I don't know.
Aha. This min-maxing doesn't make anything count in the end game, I think. Our attributes are so high and our resistances are so high that it's mainly just the question, can we deal enough damage before dying? So, and dying is pretty hard at this point, because we can always teleport out. The next dungeon will probably be harder, because there are enemies again that can one-shot you, at least what I have read from. Because I have never really finished this pyramid when I played the game back in my young days. It's probably also why I got so lost in the last episode and had to look it up. What would we do without Google in today's age, right? And now you have to imagine that you needed to finish this thing without any help of the internet. Write down all the trainers, try to figure out every puzzle yourself. All this confusing stuff. Really hard and challenging. But well,
got it.
We got the Varn chest key. And we got the doctor's code. Good shield of poison resistance. Yeah, well. Nothing else, really. So, that was this room. Now we can try to enter all the codes, I guess. Soy. Let's go back to the big room. Still some enemies down there, but I don't know how to get there, so just ignore them for now. We are here for so long. Don't count this dungeon out yet. Am I going wrong again? No. It was to the right now. Then we have to enter some more of these pools. Guess. Which one was left? Nothing here. We have to enter two more, right? Which one did I miss? Oh, there is a pitfall. I never went down there, I think. The navigator's code, yeah. Don't know this from my memory, so... Zulu, or Ulus, okay. Like this. Got it. And one more. Yes, okay, got it. Got it. Y-O-C-C-M. Y-O-C-C-M. Got this one too. And yeah, let's use the teleporter, I guess. What is the captain's code? Kirk. Like this. No. Wrote it wrong. Krik. Kirk. Okay. It's always more like a Star Wars guy, so... What? Crick. Crick. The water parts. Well, only one way to go, right? This is the other part, where we couldn't enter before. We are still taking damage. And there you see the new enemies, patrol units. Welcome to sci-fi now. Well, Still can beat them with arrows and swords, so metal doesn't matter. We have beaten dragons. Personally, the flavor checks out here. I mean, the pyramid was nice so far, but these later things are ridiculous, if you ask me. Takes somehow all the epicness away. Don't like this part at all. And we found an enforcer unit. And are we done yet? Okay, yes, there's a control cube. We found it. And all the keys are gone. So that should be it. We probably have missed a room or something. Because there were still some enemies, but, well, I will teleport the heck out of here. So, let's go to the Seer again. That is dark. Spent there most of the times. Of the days. Off we are going. Let's see. I've been you now have access to the control center. Simply ask to be transported and I will oblige. One warning, however, the guardians of the control center are no longer under my control, so please exercise caution while visiting the center. Kriegan. As I said, the Kriegan are resistant to most of the weapons available in Enroth, but not all. To rid the world of them, you will need to find where the vessel crashed and destroy the main reactor. The only problem is that the resulting explosions from the reactor will destroy this planet. You will need a powerful spell to prevent the explosion from damaging the planet, but no spell like that exists in the world today. The only person I can think of that would know of such a spell is Archibald, but he is in no condition to teach you. To make matters worse, the reactor cannot be harmed by normal weapons or spells. You will need the ancient weapons in the control center to destroy the reactor. Though my memory has been damaged by Archibald, I can still remember the danger that our ancient enemy, the Kriegan, posed to our world. The Kriegan first appeared roughly 1,500 years ago, attacking outlying colonies and stealing their resources. It was thought at the time they simply needed certain minerals and could be reasoned with, but this was not the case. The life cycle forces them to breed until the world cannot support their numbers, then they send ships off to other worlds to renew the cycle. Their attacks against the Empire of the Ancients disrupted the network of shipping and communications that held us together, causing the silence that marks the first year of our modern Salander. Without supporting from the homeworlds, our fledgling technology failed, bringing us to this sorry state. I would help rebuild our technology, but I seem to have become a religious figure in the minds of many people, and very few visit me or understand what I have to offer. Perhaps this Kriegan crisis we face will bring people to their senses, as long as we survive it. Well, and there you have it. So, we have to destroy the aliens called Kriegans, or devils by the inhabitants of Enroth. And to do this, we have to blow up their ship, and to blow up their ship, we need the ancient weapons. So our next target is to get the ancient weapons. And to get them, we also need a spell from Archibald, because if we blow up the reactor and don't have the spell, the whole planet will blow up, like a big, huge nuclear bomb. So, let's go to Iron Fist. And we still remember that Archibald is on top of it, in the King's Library, but he is set in stone. That was the end of Heroes of Might and Magic 2. So, yeah.
Halt! Master Nikolai Iron Fist, Prince and Heir to
this
the Throne of
Enroth. You want to free Archibald? If the Oracle told you to do it, I guess we should. But he will be trouble once he's loose, that's for sure. I know where the bell is that turned him to stone, but I can't open the family vault that it's in without the third eye. It's one of the three gems you need to put into the door of the vault in order to open it. I've got two of them, one in my father's crown and one in his scepter, but my father hid the third one, and he didn't tell me where it is. If you could find it, I could open the vault and get the ball. Yep, and I know where it is, because I have looked it up. Let's clean up the corpses, I guess. And it's actually in this well that didn't do anything before. That's pretty mean. Because it doesn't do anything the whole game. And suddenly you have to click there to finish this quest. And well, it's late, but anyways.
Master Nikolai Ironfist.
Got it. You found the third eye. Alright, wait here. The bell should be in the vault. Okay, here it is. So, that's the belt. Fly up. And how to do it? Maybe. Yes, now he is free again. Release Archibald. Now wait just a minute, Tanya, and I'll make it worth your while to let me... Oh. I guess I have you people to thank for releasing me from a prison of stone. Thank you. You say you need a spell that I've created? Well, as a reward, I'll give you the Ritual of Void. Use it in good health. Now I'm sure you're very busy, and as am I. And off he goes. And now we have the spell that stops the world from blowing up. That's literally it. And you can see that this lowers your reputation. But not enough to actually get Master Dark Magic. But whatever, we just pay a little bit of gold for our sins. And that's it again. Now we are average. Whatever. Yeah. Now we could go back to the Oracle and try out to get those ancient weapons, right? But before we do this, let's train a little bit, because we can now train to level 92. We have made more than 10 levels, which is ridiculous, if you ask me. So, yeah, we need to wait 1 hour.
Hey, well done.
Let's dump some of our money.
Well done. Well done. Not today.
Because what else to do with it, right?
Well done. Not today. Well done. Well done. Not today.
Well, got around 200 skill points. And yeah, well, you can have Mind Magic Expert. And, well, nothing else to spend it on, right? Let's keep 100 to dump it later into the Ancient Weapons, I guess. Nothing more to do here. Well, just spend some points somewhere. Everything is so high, I guess. We can now become Shield Master and Chain Master. I have to look it up quickly. And, well, yeah, 2 points into Dark. We can become Fire Master too now. So let me quickly check this up. So at least two are easy to reach. One is in Mist, just where the other Master Trainers were. This was Master Water, this is Master Air, this is Master Fire. Yes, Bill the Instructor. So, we are Master in Fire Magic now, so our torchlight is at least the brightest light you can get. Isn't that nice for 4000 gold? Spending it for your torchlight. And the next one is in Blackshire. This is also easily reachable. And it is in the north part of the map.
How are you today?
Somewhere here should be the Shield Master. Why are you in the way? Do I have to use Armageddon for you? Ah, this is the guy we have rescued now. Well, I'm not finding it right now. This was the temple.
Hello.
There is the Master Shields. 5000 gold. So, get the rank. So, now the armor effect is tripled, so 30 more armor class for you. That's a lot. And we have some stuff to sell.
Can I help you find anything?
Yes, you can have this. And we have still some lambs we could bring to the Dragon Sands, actually. We find an essence of accuracy. This is nice, because our Hermes shoes reduce accuracy, so I guess it's yours. Counteracted it, and yeah, I guess let's drink the luck potions. Who needs some luck? Maybe also Serena. They lower accuracy again, so it's a nice counter. And Ruxina for accuracy, sure. Drink up, girl. Drink up. And an essence of speed. Who needs speed at this point? Well, definitely not Serena. Xena can use speed. And it lowers 5 from personality, which is not useful. We've got the bell. We've got this stuff. Okay. Let's put up Day of Protection again. Hour of Power. And the Master for Chain was in Duckmoor. Unfortunately, we don't have the portal to this anymore. And it only removes our recovery penalty, so we get a little bit faster. Maybe we should get it, maybe not. Not sure. Maybe I will do it off-camera and show you later on.
Don't touch the merchandise. Come back soon.
Anywho, there are still... There's still a place, or one or two, I want to show you before we finish this. Let's see, yes, we haven't set a portal there. Yeah, maybe I can show it later. Let's go to the Oracle again, because the dungeon should be there, I think. Let's check out the place. There is now this panel, but this doesn't work. Now the question was how to get there, actually. Because there is a dungeon now with these robots. Yes, here's the control center. You can now enter this dungeon here. So, well, I can show you this place. It's very dangerous.
This place doesn't look familiar.
And this is pure sci-fi now. It's very mazy. And there is another patrol unit, and they hit the whole party with an IOE, so they shoot like very strong fireballs. And the strongest version of these guys can one-shot and eradicate party members, and there will be as much enemies as we have fought against these genies, so this is very dangerous. Blaster weapons provide an effective, accurate range attack. To operate the blasters, hold the grip conformably in your hand, point the barrel at your target, and gently squeeze the trigger. Should the weapon misfire, do not look into the barrel. Give the weapon to an instructor and let them fix the problem. Never point a blaster at something you do not want to vaporize. And this is exactly the skill for the Ancient Weapon we have now picked up. You can see here, Blaster skill. And yeah, let's dump them up to 12 or something. They are like a stronger version of the bow. And with those, and the speed of Hour of Power, you can beat any enemy in the game and shoot him to smithereens. Like, the dragons don't matter anymore, you just shoot everything you see at ridiculously high speed. I can show it to you in the dragon sense, sometimes later. And, well... still some more points. Let's put one more in light. Not that it matters that much anymore, but, well... yeah, I guess you can destroy undeads a little bit better. Let's push up a little bit more earth magic. Because there's really not much more to do. Levels don't matter that much anymore. It's now mainly just grinding to the end game. Just like this. Now we have to find the blaster weapons. And there is a chest. And more patrol units, of course. They die quickly at least. And a huge door opens. And we found our first blaster weapon. Can see they deal 23 damage, but the thing is the speed. There are even stronger ones you can earn. There we found the Terminator, and they can eradicate us, just like Minotaur Kings. And they are very healthy and very dangerous, therefore. So, one blaster is enough, all in all, to finish the last dungeon and beat the reactor. And now the rest is optional. You can try to beat this place and get an even better version of the blaster. Or you can just go to the devils now and finish the game if you wish. I try to go a little bit further, but I don't know how deep I want to go in here, because there's nothing else besides getting blasters. And I really don't like this that much. I guess I will do it to just show you the power of the blaster weapons. So let's get like 4. Then let's grab the master and expert trainer. Well, Dragon's Breath doesn't even work, so again... you can only rely on your melee against them. And they hit way harder than everything in this damn pyramid. There's another chest. Oh no, this was a chest we just got to. And for me personally, right, we were beating up some bandits with clubs, or fighted against dragons, titans, hydras, beaten skeletons, liches, some bandits here, some soldiers there, and suddenly you are fighting these robots, and in my opinion, they should have thought about something better while, like, why do the devils need to be aliens? I don't understand this. And even if they are aliens, why can't you put some hot iron into their hearts or what have you? Why do you need some robots in this game? Maybe there are people that like this idea, but I certainly don't. Shooting and shooting. They are flying up high, so can't hit them up front. And we don't deal much damage to them, so can't use magic, so...
It's fixed.
What to do?
Fixed.
Just press on, I guess. Yeah, well... Can't do anything. Please got one. Thing broken again,
fixed.
Yes.
Fixed.
Ah, it's like two. Finally.
Fixed.
Safe. Let's continue a little bit. Let's go in this direction, I guess. There is another chest. And of course a Terminator. One of our guys got terminated. The only thing you can do is resurrection. But at least we found another chest, and it's empty, unfortunately. This opens the door. Well, no more spell points to use, but spells are useless anyway here. This skill wounds a little bit. Try to continue. Still need three more blasters. The chest, and here's a big weapon, the blaster rifle, so this is the finest of personal weapons. And the ideal goal would be to give everyone the big rifle, but we have four now, so I could could end the dungeon here.
I've repaired it.
But I think we still have some time in the episode, so... Go a little bit further. Okay.
Got it.
Well, this is a small one. So we have four small ones now and one big gun. We have earned it from the Terminator units. This is a trap room. Another Terminator here. This way he shouldn't be able to hit us. Well, he found a way now. And he got another one. So we have to resurrect again. Healing Conan is really... will take forever. Because he has 1000 hit points now and... apologize for any inconvenience, but we ask that all personnel evacuate the facility at this time. Please do not be alarmed. Thank you. Well. And there are lots more Terminators. I would love to use Dragon's Breath, but it's useless, so... Well...
I've repaired it.
Terminator hits us from there. Okay, now it's in a corner. Maybe we can hit them from here, and we can. So I'm not set cheesing them. And then Enforcer, okay. Okay, now it's in a corner too. Maybe I can hit him from here. Yes, I could. Good guys. At least I can cheat them a little bit. Anything broken? Nope. Oh, this is like three of them. Got them.
Good as new.
Even with only one sword.
It's fixed.
Okay. Maybe we found another big blaster in one of those chests.
Got it.
Nope. Nope.
Got it.
Yes.
Aha.
Only two more.
Got it.
Well, more memory crystals and a control cube. Yeah, you can check out that you can't wear two. That's not possible. But you can wear one big rifle. Then you can also shoot lasers, right? Big one deals 22 damage, and the small one deals actually 23. But the attack bonus is better on the blaster rifle, but well. There were still some rooms in the beginning, I guess. This was the entrance, I think. The room to your left is the main meeting hall. Visiting dignitaries from around the world have feasted at banquets held in their honor. In fact, it's said that at this 21st birthday party, King Sheridan nearly choked to death on a piece of Mograt, but was saved by a serving girl who he later married and made his queen. Ah, l'amour. Lucky guy.
We need to go. Come
this
on.
Was the entrance. Yes. This is like another big hall. There is nothing really here. Well. So this was the meeting hall. We can go up here. This is another door. And this door is locked. There are some units behind this door. Just an enforcer. Luckily no Terminator. Got him. And another enforcer. Broken unlock something again.
As good as new.
Good. There's still nothing there. Only empty rooms. Well, and you can see more of them. I tried to go into their corner again. So I will try to chase them again. It's their own fault of running. Two more, actually. Good. And the Terminator unit. Now we probably die again. Luckily we survive him. There was nothing actually here. Well, can't I open this door? Nope, I can't. You know? Nope. Don't ask me why, but we can't open it. Let's try to open the next one. Well, only patrol units. These are fine. To use shared life now.
Good as new.
Well, I don't even drop loot because I only explode. Thing there. This connects to the upper part of this big hall. Okay. So this should also lead there. Okay, I guess that's it for this part of the map. Now only this part is left over. We can maybe explore it from here? Or can't we? Not really, I guess. So if we go here, it gets again really mazy. But these are a lot of units. Seems like the main hall of this goddamn place. Because this connects back again. Then you only have this room. And there are a lot of shots coming. Yeah, this seems to be like the end room. So I'm not bothering going there. We have our blasters. I don't want to get more. The bigger gun. We have two big guns. Let's save for our two dudes. And some smaller weapons for the girls. That's fine. Yep. Let's go back to New Sorpigo and Wizards of Dragons again. Now we have brought some firepower, I guess. And there was also a trainer for the ancient weapons here, actually.
Luck be with you.
If you remember, there was a trainer for ancient weapons in this area. And at this point, I really don't care anymore about this area. Let's turn it yellow. And here was one. The guy that was drawing. Okay. And he can teach us the way of the blaster, guys. Yes. Now we are notorious again because we killed the whole civilization of this world. But, well, I have to pay a few bucks for it. Well, we are still monstrous. And now we are fine again. And let's use the beacon to Paradise Valley, because that is where the master trainer is. Then we are masters at the blaster. Do we still have something to sell? No, you can't sell those items.
Hello.
I should be somewhere around here. But there's another reason to visit this forsaken place.
Hello. Hello. Hello.
This was the Dark Trainer.
Hello.
Where was he? He is here.
Hello, how are you?
I know that at least. Hello. Maybe in the northern part of the city.
Hello.
She is. Long ago, I found an old weapon that fired sunlight and could kill almost anything I used it against. I killed so many dragons, it got to be routine. I could shoot them out of the sky like big, slow ducks. One day, it just stopped working, and my career as a dragon slayer ended.
Yes.
Well,
okay. Yes.
We were already dragon slayers to begin with, but now we are natural dragon slayers. So, guys, let's visit the dragon sands again and clean up the space. We can reach it from New Sorpegel, right? There was the teleporter here. And now, well, we can fly and shoot those dragons with lasers. But it takes forever, literally. And it's more efficient if you don't use turn-based mode, you can see right now. But the damage is, while the damage is not high, you literally can't miss at this speed, and as you strafe, you are very hard to hit for the enemies. And, well, you just drop them like flies at one point. You can see, they are just falling wherever you are aiming right now. And, yeah, with this weapon skill, you can now finish the game, literally. However you please like, just everything melts in front of you. And it's fun for a while, but then it takes out the challenge. Something hits us the entire time, and we are weak again. Can't make use of it while weak, because then you have no haste. And that is the whole trick to it. You need the haste to, yeah, keep on the shots, literally. Exactly like this, and then you just terminate them over time. There's nothing they can do. Still some of these damn lizards survived. Where I cleaned up these chests. Those dragons can't do anything at all. They are just too slow and too big to retaliate. Yeah. Maybe we find some more artifacts in here. And even if we take some hits, it doesn't really matter. But it's so much faster than all the grinding we did here. So of course you can just go to the pyramid, get the blasters afterwards, and then clean up this whole place. And probably also the titans and what have you. It's just too easy at this point. That's also why I don't like these blaster weapons. Like, you don't need them to finish the game. And they just make the game ridiculously easy. Could have well have given us some lightsabers, I guess. That would have been more fun, because then at least you have to approach the enemies. Yeah, the breaking is also not an issue. Oh well. Let's kill some dragons. Terminated. Okay, now I need to heal a little bit. And then we continue the slaughtering. Let's get So those damn lizards. I hate them. We're always breaking our stuff, so please die now. There is the obelisk where we suicide dive to. So I guess I can now shoot the wave free to earn it. Because in the end the blasters are fair game. Because you earn them on your main quest, and the Oracle says you have to use them, even if that is a lie. But well. One. Don't take so much shit, Gold Dragon. We are official Dragon Killers. Dragon Slayers. No weapon scale, no dragon scales can protect you from these lasers. They're just melting at this point. We have nearly cleared out this goddamn desert. Can't do anything. Like the trainer said, they are just sitting ducks. Pew, pew, pew. Here are my lasers. What you gonna do? What you gonna do when we come for you? Broken. Well, your shield is broken.
As good as new.
You are the master shielder, so. Oh, got another one. This one too. And the little lizard. The lizards are the most annoying of them. So, two more and we have earned the obelisk. Want the plate armor for our trouble. And this dragon hides. He knows what awaits him. But there is no escape anymore. It's your own fault for not being a nice dragon. There are nice dragons in Mighty Magic 8 at least. They even join your group and help you to kill their brethren, so... like little pets or something. Wow, we found an artifact, at least! This is not the artifact. But I have seen the message. There was one. Let's throw the junk away. And we found Egrain. Lord Solomon Stone had this ring commissioned during the tenure as High Priest of the Past. Plus 25 spell points and of body, mind and spirit magic. Well, that is the perfect ring for a high priest. And we can now safely sell these rings of spirit magic. Because this buffs every skill of self. So our body is now at 24 and our light and our spirit and mind is also buffed. But no one cares about those anymore. I want to find more artifacts to show, but, well, at least there are some more dragons to kill. You can't escape this time, the fasters are way faster than the arrows. There is no escape. It's mainly the dragons that are dropping the artifacts, or have at least a chance to drop them. Even if the chance is quite low. Some more gauntlets. Well. There were some boots. Ok. Okay, these are not worth it. What do we have here? Large shields. Well, no, no.
Aha.
So we don't have to actually use the circus for the items. Well, ultimate boot of the eclipse. Not good enough for our team, unfortunately. This is probably also trash. Yeah, fire resistance is better in the end. This is also trash. And this is also not good. We found body and mind magic, but we have the artifact for it. And here we don't need this stuff in the end. Also don't need this anymore. Well, we still have 3 hours on this damn blaster speed. And there are still a few more dragons to kill, right? Let's grab this stuff. Then let's fly up again. Fly still lasts for 8 hours. Another blue dragon falls. Oh, this is not very good and takes up too much space. In a ring of light magic. We have an amulet, so maybe if we find another good ring. This 10 electricity resistance is not very good. What are these anymore? Well, of light magic. Well, we already had one of light magic, so never mind. Never mind, I guess. Good. Now there is the last herd of the dragons. The last dragons. Rapidly evaporating them. Let's get that one first. Good, got him. Now the golden ring. Got him. Good. And the last ones. And then this whole place is cleared out. Some more of these lizards. Got them too. And the last three enemies of this whole darn place. Then we have done it, guys. We have done it. It's nighttime, but we killed the lizards. And the dragons. And the worms. And that's literally it. Now let's take the spoils of our war on this desert. A cloak. Gauntlets, amulets. Stuff. Don't read artifact. Some books. A plate armor. Only one more quest, guys, and the book is empty. So, let's quickly check out the items.
Aha.
I don't think there's anything of worth. Well, this bow maybe. That's probably... Yeah. Who cares at bow anymore? We have the blaster, right? So... Whatever. Don't need it anymore.
I don't know.
I don't need this anymore.
I don't know.
Guess. Maybe. I'll make space. Maybe there's a good armor still.
Oh!
Definitely some good stuff, but don't need it anymore. This is also junk. And I... Well, this is actually a good one. Yeah, way better. Found a chain armor of the Phoenix. The Phoenix is probably the best armor you can get. So, what is this place? Well, I have shown you the obelisk. And if you are fast in the beginning and don't get hit, you can actually enter this place. There should be an entrance. You can go into it in the beginning. I think it was like the developer's place. Ah, yes, you can enter it from the side.
I got a bad feeling.
Right, when you go in to dodge the shots, you press the shrine to get your attribute bonus. And then you can press on this wall and enter this place. And then you go into the developer's studio, so to say. And there you find yeah, items for the beginning, like some cloaks for everybody. You find a treasure chest with some gold in there. And, well, I guess a little goblin with some gold. Right, you can find some basic equipment in here. So it's like a beginner's place that helps the early game, I guess. And here's the desk with some more armor for your guys. And there should also be a chest. Yes, like here. And if you have less than 10,000 gold, you can always come back here and take those 10,000 gold. Of course, you would need flying again. But if you start out the game with 10,000 additional gold and the 5,000 from Iron Fist and so on, you can buy a lot of good stuff. You have some basic equipment here in this place, and yeah, it's more for beginners. I did it without it, just grabbed some bows and we're still fine, right? So no big deal. There is also some additional gold and yeah. Some strong spell scrolls, like Hour of Power here. So, if you want some fun in the beginning with a stronger beginner party, and I think also a little bit more freedom of your classes, because if everyone gets 20 additional attributes and you have all the gold, you can choose whatever class you want, then yeah, why not use it, I guess. In the end, it will not matter anymore, because all that matters then is Hour of Power and Day of Protection, probably, but oh well. So, last thing to do is sell off these lamps, I guess. So we have to find our way out now again. Where was the way out again? Lost in this place, I guess. Let's just fly back in. It's at least a nice teleporter to the Dragon Sands here, so maybe you don't even need the Lloyd Beacon when the place is cleared out. Let's fly back to the caravan, I guess. Yes, and there was a guy that was searching for the lamps. And we've got the lamps, and what you get for it are just some gems and lots of money. So in the end, nothing special. So anyways, there are only two things left now. There is still the obelisk quest, and there's only one obelisk left for us in this place. We will grab it in the next episode and loot the obelisk chest. It's obelisk number one. And there are still some side dungeons. If you remember, there are two in Kriegsspire where we didn't enter, and there are no quests to it, but you can still visit them. I will try to show them to you guys. And then we are already in the final episode, where we go into the Devil's Lair and blow up the reactor and kill the queen. And that's it. So, thank you for watching. Have a nice day, and till next time. Bye bye.